Now we come to the next topic called the projection of a vector on a line. Projection of a vector on a line. It involves the concept of the scalar product itself. Projection of a vector on a line. Okay, so let A be a vector and L be a line. Okay, so let L be a line. Let L be a line and let there be a vector A. Like this. Now, what is the projection of this vector on this line L? Okay, what is the projection of this vector on this line L? See, projection is as if the sun was shining here. Okay, if this is the sun, what will be the length of the shadow? The shadow will be this long, right? Or you can say, if I drop a plumb line, that means you tie a stone at the end of a thread and tie it here, where will it touch the ground? It will touch the ground here, right? Absolutely vertical. It will go and hit the ground at 90 degrees. So this, this length, say if this is O and this is A and this is B, okay? Then OB is the projection of AA. Okay, OB is the projection of A, vector A on line L. Okay, now this can be in any way. Okay, this can be in any way. For example, it could also be like this. Could also be like this. Is it not? So OB, right? It could also be something like this. In that case, the projection on the line is the same, OB. And if it was something like this, the projection is OB, like that. We understand? This is my line L. Okay. Now, if somehow I am able to define a vector along the line, okay, somehow if I have a vector which I call here as vector B, okay, so this is a vector along this line. Okay. This is vector B. This is B. This is vector B. Okay. This is my vector B. Okay. Then what I am trying to find out? What am I trying to find out? I am actually trying to find out. Let us look from here. In triangle OAB, in first figure, okay, in figure number 1, in 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4. In one, in triangle OAB, OB upon OA is equal to cos theta, is it not? It is equal to cos theta. So what am I actually trying to find out? I am trying to find out OB, which is OA cos theta. Correct? It is OA cos theta. And what is OA? OA is nothing but the mod of A, right? Which we have already discussed. We can simply write it as A. So you remove the mod sign, you remove the arrow, and you write it as A. A cos theta. Okay? So it is A cos theta. Now let us explore our definition of A dot B. A dot B is A B cos theta. And I get alerted. I suddenly see that my A cos theta is already there. Is it not? It is already there. So what happens? A dot B, if it's already there, then what happens is, it is A cos theta is A dot B upon B. Now what is B upon B? Do we know what B upon B is? What? A vector B divided by its own magnitude. B becomes the unit vector B cap. You get it? Now automatically here you understand your A cos theta. Okay, A cos theta, this angle here was an acute angle, this angle here is an obtuse angle, this angle here is again an obtuse angle, this angle here we take this angle. No, whenever we are taking dots, we always take the smaller angle. Correct? So here you'll see the value will become negative. Here you see it will become negative. Here and here they'll become positive. Why are they positive? Because they are telling you that the projection of A is along the direction of B. You understand? In these two cases, the projection is away from B, right? In opposite direction. So that is the reason they are giving you a negative value. We understand that. So projection of A on B, projection of A on B is equal to A dot B cap. Correct? It is A dot B cap. Similarly, projection of B on A, projection of B on A will be what? It will become B dot A cap. We understand? Projection of B on A is B dot A cap. So whatever vector you are taking the projection on, that gets dotted with a unit vector, right? So if it is B on A, it's B dot A cap. A on B, A dot B cap. A on C, A dot C cap. Whatever it is on, that gets dotted as unit vector. Correct? We understand that?